Welcome to the homebrew course. In this part of the course, we will understand the difference between homebrew and cask. This is a general doubt which most of the developers have. Before talking about the formula and cask, let's summarize what we have covered till now. So that if you have missed any of the concept and you want to understand that concept, you can watch the previous videos for that. We have understood what is homebrew, what is the importance of homebrew as the entire project, how it made developers' life very convenient and improved the productivity. Then we understood each and every homebrew terminology which you have come across or you may come across while working with homebrew. We have also seen the practical examples for each of the term. If you want to understand these terms or you want to revise those, I have added the video in the homebrew course playlist. So you can access that video in the playlist section of the channel. I'll add the link in the description also. Let's get back to our topic and understand the difference between formula and cask. So both are the Ruby scripts file which are hosted on GitHub as the part of the homebrew project, and each file contains some certain information about the package, like the location of the tarball from where homebrew has to download the package, or the dependent packages which are required for that particular package to run, or the installation steps and other information required to install that particular package. So these are the information that particular Ruby file contains. So we'll see in a while that Ruby file also. So before that, let's understand the conceptual part. So if we talk about the package type, so through formula Ruby files, we can install the command line utilities. So in our Mac system, there can be two types of applications, like one can be the command line utilities or it can be the GUI based applications. To install the command line utilities, we use the formula Ruby files, and to install the GUI applications, we use the cask Ruby files, or we can say to install the macOS native applications, we can use the cask Ruby files. Then let's talk about the installation location. So the command line utilities which we have installed through the formula Ruby files are installed at this opt/homebrew/seller location. This location is for silicon based Mac systems. It would be /local/seller for the Intel based Mac systems. And for the cask applications, they will be installed in the /applications folder. We'll see shortly when we will do the practical. This is the GitHub location where this particular project is hosted. Let's open this. These are the folders in which all the Ruby files are present, which corresponds to some command line utilities. So if I open any of them, so here you can see all these are Ruby files which contains the certain information regarding the installation guidelines. So let's open this. The formula file looks like this. So you can see here it is a formula type and some description around this particular software or package. Then this is the home page for that, and some certain information is present. Okay, let's get back to our slide. Let's go to the GitHub project for the cask. So I'll open this. So here also you can see these are the folders. In each of the folder there would be some Ruby files which corresponds to some or the other application. So let's open any of them. So here you can see these are the Ruby files similar to the formula, and these corresponds to some GUI or the macOS native applications. So let's open any of them. So you can see here this is a cask type, and this is the version and the URL, and a lot of information is there which are required to install that particular application. Okay, let's get back to our slide. The project name for formula is Homebrew Core. Let's see on the GitHub project. Here you can see this is Homebrew Core. So if I click on this, you can see formula folder here. If I go inside this, you can see all the folders are here, and inside that all the Ruby files are present. The all formulas are present in this Homebrew Core project. Now let's see for the cask. So if I go to this GitHub location, then you can see here Homebrew cask is there, this is the project under which all the casts are present. And if I go inside this, so you can see all the Ruby files are present, which are responsible for the cask applications. So some of the examples for formula are like tree, gedit, git, PHP, Python, or any of the language, because they are not GUI applications. They are command line utilities. So all the languages will come under formulas. Then RabbitMQ, SQLite, etc. So here I have mentioned only a few, but there are a lot of applications and utilities present on the Homebrew project. And similarly for the cask, some of the examples are these. We can install Atom, which is an IDE, then Firefox, Google Chrome, Google Drive, Postman. So these are some of the examples which I have listed here, but you can install a lot of applications through Homebrew. So let's see in practical now. So I'll install tree application, which is a command line utility through which we can see the entire directory structure on the terminal. So let's install this and we'll see it will install in this particular location. So let's go to the terminal. The command to install any application which is a formula type, so we can do using brew install then that particular app name. So we are installing tree. So here you can see because I have already installed previously once this tree, so it is saying already downloaded this Ruby file, particular Ruby file, also the tarball, all the files will be are installed already on my system. And we have seen in the previous video that the all the files which Homebrew downloads, this is the location where Homebrew downloads each and every file. So we have seen this in the previous video. So if you want to learn about this more, you can watch that video. Let's see where it got installed now. So I'll go to cd /opt/homebrew/seller. This is the location for formula types of applications. So I'll do ls. Then there would be tree here. So it is here. So if I go to inside tree, this will be the version of that tree. So if I go to inside this, if I do ls now, so you can see all the files related to tree application are present here. In this bin, there will be binary files. So it is installed in this particular location. Now let's see how we can install a cask type of application. So let me clear the terminal first. I'll go to the home. Currently, I have not installed Firefox in this system. So let's install Firefox. So let me show you first. It is not installed. If I search here Firefox, so it will not come. This is just the DMG file. It is not the actual Firefox. To install a cask type of application, we do this using brew install, and we need to specify that it is a cask. So --cask and that application name. So that will be Firefox. If you are not sure about the exact application name, so I'll show you how we can search. So brew search, let's suppose Firefox. So it will give me all the related formulas and casks. So here you can see Firefox is there, which is a cask type of application. So I'll install this brew install --cask and the application name. So it is installing Firefox. It might take couple of minutes. So it is installed now. So if I see now Firefox, I have just typed command space. So now it is coming. So if I open this, it is just asking me for a confirmation. So the Firefox is opened. So the application is downloaded. Let's see where it has got downloaded. So if I go to the old place, which is OPT, homebrew, and then seller. And if I do ls, and let's say grab for Firefox, I'll not get anything. But if I go to application slash application, and if I do ls now, so you will see firefox.app is present. So it gets installed in this particular location slash application. Okay, let's get back to our slide. Okay, so we have seen this part, the installation part, brew install and then app name, brew install hyphen hyphen cask and then app name. So this is how we can uninstall an application. This is also pretty straightforward. Brew uninstall and then app name, brew uninstall hyphen hyphen cask app name. In the latest version of Homebrew, it has become smarter. So for the cask applications, if we type brew install and just app name and we skip the hyphen hyphen cask, then also it will detect that it is a cask type of application. So let's first uninstall the Firefox and let's try to install again without specifying hyphen hyphen cask option. So I'll go to terminal. First I will uninstall Firefox, brew uninstall hyphen hyphen cask, then Firefox. It will uninstall the Firefox. Let's wait for few seconds. So it is uninstalled now. Let me clear the terminal. Now if I install, now if I write brew install, then if I do not mention the hyphen hyphen cask and directly write Firefox, then also it is installing the cask Firefox. So it has detected that it is a cask type, so it is installing Firefox. Okay, great. So that's all for this particular video. What's next in this course? So we will do practicals around Homebrew package installation and uninstallation in depth. So we have done some part of that in this video, but we'll do this in depth and we'll understand a lot of things, like what files are downloaded when we install something, or where do they get stored in our local system, how symlinks are generated when we install any application. So all these things we will understand in depth in the next sections of the videos. Then we will explore all the commands which Homebrew supports. We will understand the symbolic links in the context of Homebrew. So I'll bring a proper dedicated video on the symbolic links. Then we will see the different Homebrew behavior for Intel and Silicon based macOS. If you found anything new through this video, please consider subscribing. Thank you all for watching this video. See you in the next video.